Hey, it's Rich, the Louisiana Hobby Guy. Well, I'm back after Hurricane Ida, and almost completely back to normal after a week of no power and no utilities. Of course, we had the backup generator, but it didn't power my computer in my remote office, so I wasn't able to get any videos done in the last week and a half. But I'm back, and we're going to get started today with a video on making a puzzle. And I've had a lot of people on other platforms send me questions or ask questions online about how to make a puzzle and how much trouble they were having setting up the puzzle, getting it to align properly with a puzzle grid. Just couldn't get it done. So there are many reasons why you can't get it done, because a lot of the puzzle grids that are out there are just not made for puzzles. It's somebody that does a grid that doesn't know what they're doing, and you know, you wind up having to make all types of kerf changes and everything else just to get it to sort of work. Well, today we're going to show you how to make it actually work. Also, I'm going to make this available on my forum website, this art library down here called Puzzles, with the different puzzle templates for you to make it easy. So let's get started. We're going to get rid of that picture right there. And we'll start by bringing in a puzzle grid. I'm going to bring in a simple one, this one right here, and we'll move it over just a bit. Now, talking about the problems that people were having, this is the biggest problem that most people have, is that most of these puzzle grids that you find online are not double cuts. So you see the double cut here? It's just a single line that divides them. So you really have to do all types of tests to get your kerf right. Well, this puzzle, or all of these puzzles here, are designed so that you don't need to worry about the kerf. Each puzzle piece is going to cut out separately, and there will be adequate space here so that you can fit them back together. And that's the number one problem that people are having, is being able to fit these puzzles back together. Now, there's also something else that I did here. Let me zoom back in again. I've created my template with an outer line. So if I click on my template and select it and then ungroup it up at the top right here, now I can click off of it and just click on the outside line like so. So what I'm gonna do is zoom way out. I'm gonna grab it in the middle and drag it off. And now we still have our puzzle, but we also have another template here for getting our picture into that puzzle. So here's the second problem that people have. I'm going to bring in a picture. This is just a free image that I got online, and I'm going to scale it up like so, so that it covers this entire square that I have over here. The next thing I'm going to do is drag over both of them so that they're both selected. I'm going to right click on it, and I'm going to apply the mask to the image. Now, once I do that, that mask is now applied to this image. And you can see here is what we're working with inside here. Not this, this is the actual image itself. So now to get it centered, and this is the problem a lot of people have, is getting the image centered. Well, in Lightburn, it's non-destructive, so we can move it to wherever we want. So let's say we're going to move it just to the right spot where we think that's the way we want it. We still have the outer box. All we have to do is right click on it again. And on this time, we have to flatten it. So flatten it will destroy the image and leave behind a cropped image for us. And there we are. So now we can take this image, drag it over here, and snap it right into our grid. And actually, I forgot a step, so let me drag it off for a second. And I'm going to drag from the bottom right up, like so, to select all of these. And I'm going to come down here, put them on a cut layer, okay, so that they'll cut out. Now I'm going to bring my image in, and I'm going to snap it right into the middle, like so. So now if we move our cut layer down, you'll actually see it. So I'm going to come over here to the priority, and I'm going to move it down one. Now you'll see the actual puzzle cutout. Now, you don't have to do things like cut shapes and, you know, all these other, there are so many tutorials out there that are so long and involved. It just takes so much time. I don't understand how people develop these tutorials, because this is the simplest way, folks. Trust me, it doesn't get easier than this. It's a three-step process. So let's take a quick peek at what we've got here, looking in the preview. And let's move down to about there. Let's go ahead and hit play. And it's finishing up. Right now it's doing the engraving. And we'll skip forward a little bit more. And now you'll see it's going to go around and cut out the puzzle pieces. Now notice that there are two lines being cut here, an inner and an outer. And that's what makes this work, is having that inner line. So now that we know how this works, there is something else too. It depends on the grid that you have, whether or not you need to do this, but there's a possibility that you may have, if you have a honeycomb bed and you're doing the cutouts, it's fine. You know, it's gonna work just fine. If you don't have a honeycomb bed, if you have one like this, which is the bed that I use, which are little spikes, these puzzle pieces might move around on you. So what I'm going to do is take advantage of one of Lightburn's features called tabs and bridges. It's right over here. It's a little icon. But I'm going to do it up here. So I'm going to double click on the layer, which is the red layer. I'm going to enable tabs and bridges. I'm just going to leave it at automatic, half a millimeter. I want 4 tabs per shape. And my tab cut power, I'm going to put at 50% of my max power, which is 85. So it'll cut at half of this power. Now, what that's going to do is it's going to put a tab, one here, wherever you see the green, one here, one here, one here, all the way around. So as you're cutting, and if you have, like what I have, you know, a raised pointy spike bed, these pieces won't fall out and damage the rest of the process. And this makes it much, much easier to get a perfect final product. And all you have to do is take your X-Acto knife once it's finished and just cut these little tabs. If you're using cardboard or 3 millimeter plywood, something like that, it works absolutely perfect. You just give it one little push with the X-Acto knife and it separates. And this will ensure that all of your pieces stay together. All your cuts are perfect. But like I said, if you have a honeycomb bed, you don't need to do this. If you don't, then enable the tabs and bridges and you'll get a perfect final result. And that's really it, folks. If we take another preview, and we just pull back just a little bit on it and hit play. So you can see after it's done all of the engraving, it's going to come back, like I said earlier, and it's going to cut out all of these pieces. And if you have a spike bed like I do, all of the pieces will stay intact on the bed. You don't have to worry about them falling out and messing up the next cut or anything like that. So there you have it. That's about it. This is about as easy as it gets. And it's really just a 3 or 4 step process. I think that Lightburn makes this so easy that anybody can do this. To just take your favorite picture, you know, you crop it out with the extra square that I put in the template, bring the picture over, set these to cut, do your tabs and bridges if necessary, and you're done. And that's how easy it is. No more problems with puzzles. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I thank you for watching.